Today we shall discuss about solid dielectric. Solid dielectrics are commonly used all kinds of electric circuit and devices. It provides insulation for current carrying conductors. Properties of good solid dielectric material. First is good mechanical strength, free from gaseous inclusion, free from moisture content, resistant to thermal and chemical deterioration, low dielectric loss, types of breakdown mechanism, intrinsic or ionic breakdown, electronic breakdown, and avalanche breakdown. Electromechanical breakdown, failure due to treeing and cracking, next thermal breakdown, electrochemical breakdown, breakdown due to internal discharge. First, we shall discuss about types of breakdown mechanism. First is intrinsic breakdown. Usually, a small number of conduction electrons present in the solid dielectric material. The following reasons, such as the small number of impurities and structural imperfection of dielectric material, are responsible for intrinsic breakdown. The impurity atoms or molecules both acts as a traps for the conduction electrons upon certain ranges of electric fields and temperature. When these ranges, the temperature ranges are exceeded, then additional electrons in addition to trapped electrons are released. The addition electrons in addition to trapped electrons will be released. Then electrons participate in the conduction process. Presence of free electrons which are capable of migration through the lattice of the dielectrics. Process will be repeated until the completion of dielectric breakdown of solid dielectric material. First is a small number of impurities such as, and next, structural imperfection of dielectric material are responsible for intrinsic breakdown. These are the reasons for breakdown. Okay. Next, the ranges, when these ranges, temperature or electric field ranges are exceeded, then electrons in addition to trapped electrons will be released, these electrons participate in the conduction process. Presence of free electrons will have the capable of migration through the lattice of the dielectrics. This process will be repeated until the completion of dielectric breakdown of solid dielectric material. There are two types of intrinsic breakdown mechanism. First is electronic breakdown and streamer breakdown or avalanche breakdown. Electronic breakdown will occur due to the presence of large density free electrons in a solid dielectrics. Electronic breakdown will occur due to the presence of what? Due to the presence of large density free electrons in solid dielectric. Whenever high voltage is applied, collision between large free electrons will take place. Whenever high voltage is applied, what happens? Collision between large free electrons will take place. Result of that, electrons gain energy from the electric field and cross the forbidden energy gap from the valence to the conduction band. Eventually, the electric breakdown takes place. Next, avalanche or streamer breakdown. Similar to the breakdown in gaseous dielectric, avalanche breakdown or streamer breakdown, you have learned in gas dielectric, solid dielectric, liquid dielectric, we have learned purification breakdown test. What about in gas starting introduction part? We have learned in streamers or avalanche theory. Okay. Similar to the breakdown in gaseous dielectric, avalanche breakdown or streamer breakdown is a phenomenon that can occur in both in insulating and semiconducting materials. It is a form of electric current multiplication that can allow very large current within materials and causes dielectric breakdown. First step is the formation of avalanche, and next step is avalanche creates a space charge, that is a collection of charge or cloud of charge. Space charge leads additional electric field. That electric field enhances the growth of new avalanche. Ionized region grows quickly and expands when the energy gained by the electrons greater than lattice ionization potential formation. Then avalanche takes place. That is a condition for avalanche breakdown. Breakdown occurs when avalanche exceeds critical size and formation of many avalanche breakdown will be occurred. It is, this theory is similar to gaseous dielectric. Okay, in that also same phenomena they will apply. Avalanche breakdown, it is a form of electric current multiplication that will allow large currents within the materials and it will cause a dielectric breakdown. First step is formation of avalanche and next it will create a space charge. That space charge will lead to a additional electric field. That electric field enhances the growth of new avalanche. That new avalanche ionized region grows quickly and expands when that energy gained by the electrons greater than the lattice ionization potential formation, then avalanche takes place. That is what condition for avalanche breakdown. Breakdown will occur when avalanche exceeds critical size and formation of many avalanche breakdown will be occurred. This is the diagram for that. Electromechanical breakdown. First, we need to consider the these reasons for the electromechanical breakdown. First is solid dielectrics are subjected to high electric fields. Solid dielectrics are subjected to high electric fields. And next is electrostatic compressive forces which can exceed the mechanical compressive strength. How do you calculate the maximum value of electric field strength? Before the breakdown, first consider a solid dielectric material and thickness of solid dielectric material is DO and applied voltage is V and thickness after the applied voltage is D. That means material is compressed. Epsilon naught permittivity, this is the permittivity, epsilon naught and epsilon R V square divided by 2D square is equal to Y ln D naught divided by D. This is the equation for what? How do you calculate the maximum value of electric field strength before the breakdown? That equation 1 represents the electrically developed compressive stress in equilibrium, where Y is the Young's modulus. And from equation 1, find the voltage. Okay, find the voltage. V square is equal to D square open bracket 2y divided by epsilon naught and epsilon r close bracket ln D naught divided by D. Usually mechanical instability occurs when it will occur D divided by D naught is equal to 0.6 or it may be D naught divided by D is equal to 1.67. Next, substitute what equation 3 in 2. Okay, the highest apparent electrical stress, the highest apparent electrical stress or maximum value of electric field before breakdown is given by E maximum. This is it. Before breakdown, E maximum is equal to V divided by D naught. E maximum is equal to V divided by D naught is equal to, we know the value of that is 0.6 Y divided by V value is, this is the equation. Okay, V is equal to square root of this equation. Okay, if you solve that, you will get 0.6 Y divided by epsilon naught and epsilon R to the power of 1/2. Next is thermal breakdown. Most of the insulation failures in high voltage power apparatus occur due to the thermal breakdown. Most of the insulation failures in high voltage power apparatus occur due to what? Thermal breakdown. Thermal means heat. Okay. Due to temperature, high heavy temperature, breakdown will occur in apparatus. When an electric field is applied to a dielectric, conduction current, however small, it may be close to the material. when the electric field is applied to a dielectric, conduction current will flow through the material. The current heats up the specimen and the temperature will be rising. The heat generated is transferred to the surrounding medium by conduction through the solid dielectric and by radiation from its outer surface. Heat generated is transferred to the surrounding media by conduction through the solid dielectric and by radiation from its outer surface. Mathematical expression for thermal breakdown is the heat generated under DC stress E is given as WDC is equal to E to the power of 2 n sigma, where sigma is the DC conductivity of the specimen. Under AC fields, the heat generated omega WAC is equal to E square F epsilon R tan delta divided by 1.8 into 10 to the power of 12. F is a frequency in hertz, delta is a loss angle of the dielectric material. And the heat dissipated is given by WT is equal to CV dT by dT d capital T divided by d small t plus DIV open bracket K grad T close bracket. What is CV? CV is a specific heat of the specimen and T is the temperature of the specimen and K is a thermal conductivity of the specimen and small t is the time over which the heat is dissipated. Normally WAC or WDC equals to WT, that is heat dissipated. Breakdown occurs when WAC or WDC greater than WT.